Hey, 10 of Diamonds, July 5th. Saw Ben from Hollywood. Still moving slow coming out of the event transfer tonight. Well, I got quite a bit to report, and let me get right to it. I started first in the tunnel. It became right around 3 minutes after five. It turned into a labyrinth of woven gold and vibrated and was soft, and it felt delicious like honey. And I started to speed through it, and I could hear the thoughts of the other people connected to this etheric form. I could hear music coming out of somebody's head, and I could also hear really negative thoughts coming out of another person's head who was like really severely disturbed by all this. And at the very end, I picked up a black Latino woman with curly Q tattoos who got something really heavy, but is trying to stuff it into religion, and she's terribly, terribly twisted by that. If you're there, email me and we'll go over that, because the facts are facts and beliefs are, you know, nothing. All right, so as I go through Europe, what I pick up is all this confusion and disinformation is really 1984, so out of control. Europe doesn't even really get what the heck they're doing. So here comes Sarkozy, the Antichrist. He teams himself up with Iran. And as we know, you saw Iran taking baseball bats to old women. This is not a nice bunch of guys. That's the Mohammed religion, no matter what they tell you. It's a very violent religion. Well, Christianity is too. And they hit all the Nazi priests in the Protestant churches. So, I mean, what gives? Is God a guy that goes out and kills people? Well, he does have hurricanes, and he does kill people. So maybe the Jesuits were right when they taught me as a young boy that that God is going to be replaced by somebody more suitable, and that gods are localized. That does seem to make a lot more sense, but that's going to shatter the belief systems that are stuck in those ruts. All right, anyway, back to Sarkozy. I was then taken into the presence of a giant, I would say probably as tall as about a four-story building, and in a darkened like cave, and he brought reality in like on little television sets, and he showed me that at the base of all this problem is the Pope, this weaselly little rat, the Pope. He's at the basis of all this, and he wants to stir up war, because apparently he's in with those families in America now who are in with the Queen, and they're just a bunch of vandals. You know, they sell drugs, they start wars, they make bullets, they do the most horrible things imaginable while they're sipping their tea. Now, that's because they're of different blood than you and me. They're either of that reptilian blood or that Martian blood. Check out what Rush Limbaugh, I have posted and you can get it on Google, what Rush Limbaugh said about Mars from paperwork he got from generals. It's the same thing I remote viewed on Mars, that the society was dispersed about 50 years ago to reorganize the reality on that planet. Are they connected to us? Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah. The bad guys are everywhere. This war that's actually going on in the universe is one of morality. It's one of decency. It's one of allowing people to survive. But the key element that I'm picking up from this is it's out of control. What happened here, it's gotten out of control. They can't do anything about it anymore. And they're piecing reality together, apparently, in Iran. Let's see what else we got here. Sarkozy. They try to blame the Muslims and the Pope. Nobody's really sure who kills him. But what I saw was him driving in a limousine. It would almost look like an old junkyard with a lot of rusty material. And he went by a building with rounded windows like a greenhouse that was rusty. It exploded. He died. That was it. And they're trying to blame it on everybody. I picked up a little bit of alien presence in that they don't even want to soil their hands on something like this. This sort of disgusts them, and they are actually labeling the human race by this, because of all the disinformation we've been given, the basis of our reality is disgusting to them. Now, the bad families like the Bushes and the Vanderbilts and all these other billionaire families who have screwed the place up want to take off. They originally wanted to go to the moon, but they were rejected by all those mining groups on the moon from different planetary systems getting out the helium-115. They don't want them there, you know, so now they're going to try Mars. They're not wanted at Mars. You see, they blew up the last eight rockets to Mars, so they don't want them on Mars, but they're going to try to go anyway. And so that's going to create some real problems. Now, during that surge, as I mentioned to you, I was reading the thoughts of others, and I heard music in one guy's head, and the girl with the tattoos. And as I drifted out of that, I sort of sensed the thoughts of other people that, you know, just couldn't create an image or had religious blockage or their mind was going too fast. They were trying to figure it all out. But I heard them like distant instruments, like the saxophone and then the chimes and the cello, you know, separating the sounds in an orchestra. Okay, so what else do we have here? Uncertainty is the problem in Europe, is the reason Sarkozy was able to do so well. People just don't know what to do. I cut off at 5:30. I was getting piled up drifting thoughts. What else here? Let's see. Again, the giant pointed out these evil families and what they're up to, and how they're going to have a lot of problems out in space themselves, and they're not going to do too well. And some of the ones that go into the underground cities are liable to actually be crushed by earthquakes. So that's pretty much what I got. And you know what you get. Thank you.